Okay, so this will be a very unfair comparison between Martin Logan's Scenario and Martin Logan Ascent I. The Scenario was built in 1999 and the Ascents are from 2005 based on serial numbers. You can see the difference in the size, of the bus speaker and panel size. What else? Both speakers have been upgraded with new capacitors in crossovers. I've replaced four capacitors in Ascents and I've used bypass capacitors in Scenarios. So the Scenarios upgrade was way cheaper than the Ascents upgrade. They are driven with very, very different equipment. And that's what makes the comparison a bit unfair, because Ascents are being driven by Cambridge Audio Azur 851D, which is connected through Audioquest Water XLR cables to double Cambridge Audio Azur 851W, which are connected in bridged biamping. Which basically means that each one of them serves one channel only, and one channel of each amplifier is dedicated to high highs, and the second channel is dedicated for bus driver. This basically means that there should be no crosstalk between channels whatsoever, because the 851D has also a very high crosstalk parameter. I think it was something like 80 or 90 decibels. Both DAC converters are connected to fanless PC that's standing behind the TV set. The Scenarios are being driven by cheap Chinese AK 4493 DAC, which actually uses two DAC chips, each for one channel, and it's connected through some cheap AudioQuest cable to another cheap Chinese power amplifier, Class D TPA 3116D2 solution, which gives 50 watts per channel into 4 ohms. It was very, very cheap. It has bus and treble regulation, but they are not scaled, so it's very hard to set both bus and treble to zero. I've done my best using my ears. Both setups are ear matched to the same volume level, and I'll be changing the volume using software knob on the football player. What else about the setup C file? Think about something more. I'll put it in the description under the video. But what's important here is that there is a staggering price difference between these two setups. The first setup, Ascents and Cambridge Audio set, were costing something like, I don't know, $5,000. And the second setup, Martin Logan Scenarios and two Chinese devices, were like $700, maybe even less. Another difference is that the Ascents are standing on spikes, and the spikes are placed on granite plinths, which are disconnecting the speaker from the plywood floor here. The Scenarios are standing on the factory flat metal feet, not spikes, nothing that could be disengaging them from the floor. Ascents are also using AudioQuest power cables and AudioQuest speaker cables. The Scenarios are using very cheap printer cables as a power cables, and they are using quite nice QED silver cable, but I do not remember the exact model of the cable. I will put that in the description. So the last important difference is that the Ascents are standing in the sweet spots in this room. This room had been acoustically treated. I have acoustic panels on the back, which you cannot see at the moment. The Scenarios are standing as close as possible to these two sweet spots. They are angled the same way, but nevertheless this affects the imaging. Also, the equipment affects the imaging. Sorry, that was some noise from the street. The idea is to go through some of my eclectic music collection, changing the setup on the fly using full bar settings. You'll be able to see when I'm changing the setup, and you'll also be able to see the bitrate of the music. Both DAC converters are connected using USB and using ASIO drivers dedicated for the equipment. The Chinese DAC is using a Monero solution for the USB port, and Cambridge Audio uses some kind of their own developed connector with dedicated ASIO driver. Okay, so let's start. I'll be jumping through the tracks, and I'll be running through them for 10 or 15 seconds to give you the idea of the differences between the speakers and between the setups. So let's start with this one. And the first device is Ascent. Okay, let's end the room.
With the prayer queen preaching Jesus in the middle of the square. Young kid playing yesterday on a Japanese guitar. There's a loser on the talk show.
Switch.
He wants a star. And Sharon sings for Wayne. In a karaoke bar. There's a superstar who fell from grace. He has to tell it all. About the dizzy heights he rose to. And his ignominious fall.
These are few scenarios. Scenarios. being recorded by the phone, so I'm not sure if you'll be able to see to hear the differences in my imaging. Probably not. Sorry about that, but I'm going on random. Ascents, and now switch to scenarios. switch. This one is very good for testing detail, string detail. Switch. Switch. Ascents. Differences that you couldn't probably hear because of the crappy phone microphone. The more expensive setup has a holographic stage. You can clearly hear the depth and height and width of the scene. The cheaper setup doesn't have that quality, though it's still very, very good in that regard. The stereo scene is very wide, and do mind that the scenarios are not standing in the best possible spots. So it's still very, very good for that kind of setup. There are differences in timbre. The Ascents with Cambridge audio sound more flat, more natural. The scenarios with these Chinese devices seem to sound like they would be having some kind of small loudness engaged. But maybe that's the quality of the speaker, because scenarios were meant as home cinema speakers, while Ascents were meant as hi-fi speakers. So maybe that's the difference. I do some testing. I switch the scenarios to Cambridge Audio setup before I'll move them downstairs because they won't be used in this room. Anyway, what I wanted to say in the end is that both sets of speakers are great, and I was amazed by the quality of scenarios driven by these Chinese devices, because this is a very cheap setup and this is something I could live with, and I would be happy living with it. Downstairs the scenarios will be connected to a 9 setup, but basically if you spend I'd say something like 100 bucks, yeah, $100 for this Chinese amp and this Chinese digital analog converter, you're also having a great devices to listen to music. And that's all. If you have any questions, please ask me them in the comments. I can connect both of them at the same time to Cambridge Audio setup, but the problem is that I wouldn't be able to switch off one pair or another without basically going behind them and unplugging the cables while playing live. I do have some kind of speaker switch, but it's connected downstairs to some other equipment, and it would be too much hassle to disconnect it and take it upstairs. Okay, thank you. I hope you enjoyed this video.